In the previous lecture, we learned about the water property tables for saturated, superheated, and compressed liquid states. I explained how the oversimplified linear interpolation is in no way the best option we have in terms of numerical analysis and more accurate interpolation methods, yet it's what most, if not all, textbooks and instructors use for a thermo course. And to be fair, the percentage error is not negligible, but it's low enough for thermodynamics designs to work properly. So let's see how we use interpolation to find values that these tables are not showing, and we'll quickly compare one of the values to the alternatives I mentioned in that lecture. Using what we learned about TV diagrams in the previous 13-minute lecture, link below, we want to find the specific volume of water at 600 kilopascals and 300 degrees Celsius. If it's not completely apparent what phase the water is in, we can use our saturated tables to see what the saturation temperature is for 600 kilopascals or what the saturation pressure is for 300 degrees Celsius. If we use the pressure table for saturated water, we see that for a pressure of 600 kilopascals, the saturation temperature is 158 Celsius. Therefore, we know that at 300 Celsius, our water is superheated vapor. We then go to our superheated table, and just like it was explained during an example of the previous lecture, link below, we see that within our table, we have subtables for different pressure values. We look for the pressure we need, in this case 600 kilopascals, or what is the same, 0.6 megapascals, and we see that our temperature is listed there. Since what we're looking for is the specific volume, and that's the first column value, we're done. The specific volume for water at 600 kilopascals and 300 degrees Celsius is 0.43442 cubic meters per kilogram. Now, what if our pressure is still 600 kilopascals, but now the temperature is 330 degrees Celsius? Since that value is not in the tables, we would have to interpolate. And again, a linear interpolation is not the best option we have because what we're basically doing in this TV diagram is assuming that the different values that we have between, for example, these two points in a superheated region, is linear. We're basically saying that this plot looks like this. Of course, I'm exaggerating. We'll later see that for compressed liquids, we'll even assume the specific volume to just be the saturated liquid value, VF. So to sum up, linear interpolation is not the most accurate way to do this, but it is very common practice, and possibly what your thermo professor wants from you. So here it is. We have a specific volume value for 300 degrees Celsius, and a value for 350 degrees Celsius. And we want that value for 330 degrees Celsius. Since we're assuming a linear behavior between these points, the slopes should be the same between 300 and 350, 300 and 330, and 330 and 350. Since we have the values for V for 300 and 350, we'll definitely use those for one of the slopes, rise over run, or 350 minus 300 over 0.47 minus 0.43. And we use any of the remaining two, green or blue. Let's go with green. Rise would be 330 minus 300, and run would be the V we're looking for, minus 0.43. We equate these two slopes and we solve for V. This would be the specific volume for 600 kilopascals and 330 degrees Celsius. Now, the alternative to interpolating is to use computational resources that have more accurate values than our unrefined method of interpolation. And it's as easy as looking it up online to find a good tool that has values for steam, or just use computer programs like EES, Engineering Equation Solver. If you want to learn how to use it, there's a link in the description down below to a very short video example where we look this up using EES. If we use any resource online, for example this one, we can click on the Superheated Steam Table option on the left pane and input our pressure and temperature values, in this case 600 kilopascals and 330 degrees Celsius. Just make sure that the units are what you need. And done! We have our specific volume of 0.45 cubic meters per kilogram. This is close but not identical to our interpolation, and it's most of the time a lot quicker than interpolating. Now, what about the values that are between the saturated liquid and the saturated vapor? Or what is the same, the saturated mixture region values? Quality is the property that helps us identify where along the path inside the saturated dome we are. We use the variable x for it, and it's defined as the mass of vapor relative to the total mass. This implicitly means that a quality of 100% or 1 is all vapor, meaning saturated vapor. And of course, if quality is 0, mass of vapor is 0, meaning it's all liquid. Saturated liquid is therefore 0 quality. The total mass is the mass of the fluid plus the mass of the gas or vapor. Defining this property is useful because for systems where we have a constant volume, finding the overall specific volume in terms of the specific volume of the saturated liquid VF and the specific volume of the saturated vapor VG is very straightforward. If the total volume of a saturated mixture is fixed, and that's volume, not specific volume, the volume is composed of VG plus VF. We can write the volume as the product of mass times specific volume for all three terms, write the mass of the fluid as the total mass minus the mass of the vapor, divide by total mass, and recognize that mg over total mass is our quality. And this expression can be rearranged to v equal to x times vg minus vf plus vf. Let's see how what we learned about quality is applied with a simple example, and if you want to check some examples where we use what we learned about both interpolation and even double interpolation, pressure and temperature at the same time, make sure to check out the links in the description of this video. Those are really important. What is the phase and pressure of water with a specific volume of 30 cubic meters per kilogram and a temperature of 30 degrees Celsius? What is the quality X if applicable? Remember to pause here and try to solve this problem without watching the solution just yet. If we draw our TV diagram, we know we are located somewhere along the 30 degrees Celsius temperature. Since we first need to know if we have compressed, saturated, or superheated water, we can look up the VF and VG values for 30 degrees Celsius and compare our current specific volume to those. If V is lower than VF, we have compressed water. If V is greater than VG, we have superheated water. And if V is between VF and VG, we have a saturated mixture. Since VF is 0.00104, and VG is 32.879, our current V of 30 cubic meters per kilogram means that we have saturated water. Because of this, we know that the pressure has to be the saturation pressure, otherwise we wouldn't have saturated water. If our current specific volume was greater than VG, the pressure would be lower than Psat, and we would be located on the line that represents that pressure. And if our current specific volume was less than VF, the pressure would be higher than Psat, and we would be located on the line that represents that pressure. We would use the superheated vapor and the compressed liquid tables, respectively. But since our specific volume is between VF and VG, we have a saturated liquid vapor, and therefore the pressure is the saturation pressure. And with these values, we can easily use the expression we just defined to solve for and calculate our quality X. Like I said before, there's some links in the description below where you'll find some examples for interpolating values from property tables, as well as some examples where we use quality as a given information to solve for properties of our substance. You'll also find the links to other lectures of the thermodynamics course, as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching.